Hi, my name is Jason Krueger, and I'm the middle school theater director.
And I'm Alec Warren, the middle school choir director. Together, Jason and I collaborated to produce and direct Matilda, our middle school spring musical from the 7th and 8th grade mixed choir class.
As you can see, we are in the Dell Fine Arts Center on the Upper School campus. Today, May 8th, 2020, we should be preparing for our opening night of Matilda, but we are not opening tonight.
We are sitting here on an empty stage. No set, no orchestra, no costumes, just an empty stage with no audience.
If we were opening tonight, you would have been given a program when you walked into the theater. On the first page would have been my director's note. So think of this as my director's note. Whenever I write a director's note, I try to do two things. First, give background about the show, and second, share a little bit about our process. Matilda is a musical based on the children's book by famed author Roald Dahl. It tells the story of a special young girl, perhaps a genius even, surrounded by horrible, self-absorbed parents and a mean and cruel headmistress that hates children. Matilda, with the help of some special powers and a meek but kind teacher, is able to overcome these obstacles and still find the beauty in humanity.
We began working on Matilda back in December of this year, and were well on our way into the process when the COVID-19 pandemic struck the world and brought everything to a grinding halt. On the fly, we had to figure out a way to create musical theater in a completely new medium that would still tell the story and honor the work of these kids. What we have created is a virtual performance that took many hours to create each video and, through trial and error, put together a final product that we and these students are proud to share.
We hope that as you watch this performance, you will be reminded, like Matilda, that art will always find the truth and beauty in this world. Whether you're watching this for the first time or perhaps somewhere down the road, we hope this offers a glimpse into a moment in time when, even though the world around us stopped, these amazing students persevered through the obstacles and created something beautiful. Parents, thank you so much for your support. Students, we can't thank you enough for your willingness to be resilient through this process. We are so proud of you. And to our eighth graders, we love you so much. Though your middle school years didn't end the way we hoped, we know you will all be stronger because of this experience.
Students and families, thank you so much for an incredible first year at St. Andrews. You have been kind, welcoming, and so committed to the art we have created. I'm lucky to be your teacher.
Now I will end this director's note as I have every director's note for the past 24 years. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Thank you.
My mommy says I'm a miracle. My daddy says that I'm a special little gal. I am a princess. Mom says I'm an angel sent down from the sky. My parents are so proud to have a daughter as clever as me. They are very, very, very proud. They always say, Matilda, we are so proud to have a daughter as... That's not true. That's not what they say. They're not proud at all. They call me a liar and a nasty little creep. My mom says I'm a good case for population control. My dad says that I should watch more TV.
I know I learned from telly, this been beautiful box of facts. If you know a thing already, baby, you can switch channel off just like that. Endless joy, endless laughter, folks living happily ever after. All you need to make you wise is 23 minutes plus advertisement. Why would we waste our energy turning the pages 1, 2, 3? We could sit comfortably on a lovely balcony, watching people singing and talking and doing stuff. All I know, I learned from telly. The bigger the telly, the smarter the man. You can tell from my big telly just what a clever fella I am.
Yes, sir. That's right, sir. 155 brand new luxury cars, sir. Are they good runners? Let's put it this way. You wouldn't beat them in a race. No, sir. Yes, sir. They're very good runners. So how much exactly?
Harry, she's reading a book. That's not normal for a 5-year-old. I think she might be an idiot.
Hang on.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom.
Stop scaring your mother with the book, boy.
I'm a girl.
And she keeps trying to tell me stories, Harry. Stories. Who wants stories? It's not normal for a girl to be all thinking.
Would you please shut up? I'm trying to close the biggest business deal of my life, and I've got to listen to this. You know what? This is your fault. You spend us into trouble and expect me to get us out of it like some flaming escapologist.
You, an escapologist? I have a whole house to take care of. Dinners don't microwave themselves, you know. If you're an escapologist, then I must be an acrobat to balance that lot. The world's greatest acrobat. Now, I'm off to dye my roots, and I shan't be talking to you for the rest of the evening, you horrid little man.
But I'm gonna make us rich.
Rich? How rich?
Very rich. Russian businessman, very stupid. Your genius husband is gonna sell him 155 banged up knackers as, get this, brand new luxury cars.
But that's not fair. The cars will break down. What about the Russians?
Fair. Listen to the boy.
I'm a girl.
Fair doesn't get you anywhere in this world, you thick-headed twit brain. Now all I can say is I'm thankful that Michael got some of his old man's brain, eh, son?
My girl.
Well, I shall take the money when you earn it, and I shall spend it, but I shan't enjoy it because of the despicable way in which you have treated me tonight.
We are told, but surely
you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if you're little, you can do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top of you, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. In the slip of a boat, there's a tiny revolt. In the seat of a wall, in the creak of a floorboard, a storm can begin with a flap of a wing. The tiniest mite packs the mightiest sting every day. Starts with a tick of a clock, all escapes. Starts with a click of a lock. If you're stuck in your story and want to get out, you don't have to cry, you don't have to shout. Cause if you're little, you can do a lot. You must let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top, you won't change a thing. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, it's not right. And if that's not right, you have to put it right. But nobody else is gonna put it right for me. Nobody but me is gonna change my story. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
This is all your fault with your stupid books and stupid reading.
What? But I didn't do anything. That's not right.
Oh, right. Right. Well, you're off to school in a few days' time, and you won't be getting much right there. Oh, no. I know your headmistress, Agatha Trunchbull, and I've told her all about your little smarty-pants ideas. Great big, strong, scary woman she is. She used to compete in the Olympics, throwing the hammer. I can't even imagine what she's going to do to you, you squeaky little goblin boy.
I'm a girl.
Off to school, you little bookworm.
Mummy says I'm a miracle.
My daddy says I'm his special little guy.
I am a princess.
I am a prince.
Mum says I'm an angel.
Mum says I'm an angel.
Mum says I'm an angel. And so you think you're able to survive this mess by being a prince or a princess, you will soon see there's no escaping tragedy. And even if you put in heaps of effort, you're just wasting energy, cause your life as you know it is ancient history. I have suffered in this jail, I've been trapped inside this cage for ages, this living hell, but if I try I can remember that before my life had ended, before my happy days were over, before I first heard the pealing of the bell. And you were most curious, so innocent I asked a thousand questions, but unless you want to suck on this and I will teach you a thing or two. You listen here, my dear, you'll be punished so severely if you step out of line, and if you cry it will be double, you should stay out of trouble and remember to be extremely careful.
Who was that lady?
That lady? That was Miss Honey. She's going to be your teacher.
That lady? That lady is my...
Yes, yes, your teacher. Now look, are you going to tell me a story or not?
Once upon a time...
Knock on the door, Jane. Just knock on the door. Don't be you're pathetic. Knock on the door, Jenny. There's nothing to fear. You're being pathetic. It's just a door. You've seen one before. Just a knock on the door. Look at you trying to hide, silly. Standing outside the principal's office. And look, a little girl is just pathetic. Hesitating, hands shaking. You should be embarrassed. You're not a little girl, it's just pathetic. Knock on the door, Jenny. What are you waiting for? Just knock on the door. Perhaps she'll wait. She's probably having a meeting or something. You won't want to be interrupted. If anything, caution the situation is sensible. One should avoid confrontation if possible. I'll come back later then. But this little girl, this miracle, knock on the door, Jenny, just knock on the door, don't be pathetic.
Enter! Well, don't just stand there like a wet tissue, get on with it.
Well, yes, Miss Trunchbull, there's in my class, there's a little girl named Tilda Wormwood, and...
What is the school motto, Miss Honey?
Baminatum est magitum.
Baminatum est magitum. Children are maggots. What about rules, Miss Honey, rules?
See, now my trophies gleam in the sunlight, see how they shine. What do you think it took to become English hammer throwing champion 1969? Do you think in that moment, when my big moment came, that I treated the rules with casual disdain?
Like hell!
As I stepped into the circle, did I change my plan? What? As I dropped my palms, did I wave my hands? I did not! As I started my spin, did I look at the view? Did I drift off and dream for a minute or two? Think I faltered or amended my rotation? Do you think I altered my intended elevation? As the hammer took off, did I change my grunt? From the grunt I had practiced for many a month. Not a jot, not a dot, did I stray from the plot? Not a detail of my throw was adjusted or forgotten. Not even when the hammer left my hand and sailed high up, up above the stands. Did I let myself go? No, 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 no. Going to throw the hammer for your country. You have to stay inside the circle all the time. And if you want to make the team, you don't need happiness or self-esteem. You just need to keep your feet inside the line. Trotter.
Yes, miss?
You liked my cake, didn't you, Bruce?
Yes, Miss Trunchbull, and I'm very sorry, but...
Oh, so long as you enjoyed the cake, that's the main thing.
Is it?
Yes, Bog Trotter, it is.
Oh, well, I did. Thank you.
Wonderful. Marvelous! That makes me so happy. It gives me a warm glow in my lower intestine. Oh, cool! What's the matter, Bog Trotter? Lost your appetite?
Well, yes, I'm full.
Oh, no, you're not full. I will tell you when you are full, and I say that criminals like you are not full until you have eaten the entire cake.
But...
haven't got time for what? Eat!
But I can't eat it all.
You should have thought of that before you made a pact with Satan and decided to steal my cake! Eat!
He can't!
Eat!
He surely can't!
Eat!
Might explode!
Eat!
A single slice, or even two, Bruce, might have been nice. But even you, Bruce, have to admit, between your lit, there's not a lot of difference in size.
He can't,
he surely can't,
he surely can't,
you are the man, Bruce. He might explode,
he's quite elastic,
he's going to blow, make him stop,
he's fantastic, look at him go.
I can't watch, I think in effect, this must confirm, Bruce, what we all suspected. You have a worm, Bruce, or maybe a largeness, it's like the TARDIS. She'll call a truce, Bruce. With every swallow you are tightening the noose. We never thought it was possible, but here it is coming true. We can have our cake and eat it too. The time has come to put that tumbling tongue to use. No excuse, Bruce. Let out your belt, I think you'll want your trousers loose. Oh, stuff it in, you're almost finished. Whatever you do, just don't give in. Don't let her win. Come on, Bruce, be our hero. Cover yourself in chocolate glory.
Come on, Bruce, do it.
Silence, Bruce.
You'll never again be subject to abuse. For your immense caboose, she'll call a truce. Just one more bite and you've completely cooked a goose. We never thought it was possible, but here it is coming true. We can have our cake and eat it.
when I grow up. I will be brave enough to fight the creatures that you have to fight beneath the bed each night to be a grown up.
The chalk. Look, the chalk. It's moving. It's writing something. Agatha, this is Magnus. Give my Ginny back her house. Then leave, or I will get you like you. You got me. Now run, run, run!
She take away my freedom, and we won't forget the day we fought.
For the rest to be a little bit naughty. Never again
will the jokey goes wrong.
Never again
will I be bullied out.
Never again
will I doubt it when
my mommy says I'm a miracle. Never again will we live behind bars. Never again I'm a we. Now we are revolting children living in revolting times. We sing revolting songs using revolting rhymes. We'll be children till our revolting's done, and we'll have the trench for bolting. We're revolting. We are revolting children living in revolting times. We sing revolting songs using revolting rhymes. We'll be revolting children till our revolting's done, and we'll have the trench for bolting. We're revolting.
It will become a screaming horn.
We'll find out where the chalk is stored
and draw rude pictures on the board.
It's not an insulting, we're revolting.
We can ask PL how we like.
If enough of us are wrong, wrong is right.
Everyone is O-R-T-Y.
Cause we're a little bit naughty, so we gotta stay inside the line. If we disobey at the same time, there's nothing that the trench wall can do.
You didn't think you could push us too far, but there's no going back now. We
Miss Trunchbull. She was never seen again. The Cherokees were immediately destroyed and a new headmistress took over. And do you know something else? Matilda was never again able to move things to the eyes. I thought perhaps it was because her mind was being challenged, but she said it was because she no longer had a need for superpowers. And sometimes I look at Matilda, this little girl who had done so much to help others, but who was stuck with parents who were mean and cruel and called her names. And I would feel my blood boil, and I would wish that I could just do something. Matilda, would you like to come stay with me?
Yes, yes, I do.
And Matilda leapt into Miss Honey's arms.
And hugged her.
And Miss Honey hugged her back, because they had found each other.
Yes, they had found each other.